Good evening, everybody. Good evening. And once again, welcome to yet another one-shot session of our biology NEET class on the chapter Animal Kingdom. I hope you all can hear me properly. One second. Yes, guys, 1 second. Yes, I hope you all can hear me properly. Yes, hit the chat box with the thumbs up, everyone. If everything is crystal clear, the video, audio, everything is clear, hit the chat box with the thumbs up. So that let's get started. I will get to know that you can hear me properly, so that let's get started. Yes, everyone. Thank you so much. Dima, IO is there. Calvin is there. Guys, please wait for 1 second. Please wait for 1 second. We'll start off right now. Okay, everyone. So today we are having the class on the chapter Animal Kingdom. We are having the one short session on this amazing chapter, which is actually frequently one of a difficult chapter, which is recommended by the students. So let's get started with this chapter. Before moving on to the chapter, once again reminding you, those who are watching the session for the first time or watching the sessions of our channel for the first time, don't forget to join our Telegram group at t.me/neet_biopoint, where regular daily session updates, discussion, polls and quizzes, everything happens off. And those who are watching the session right now, don't forget to hit the like button and share it with your friends. And those who are brand new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe this amazing channel. So I want each one of you, I'll give you 2 minutes for each one of you to take out your NCRT by your side. Open out your NCRT class 11th on the chapter Animal Kingdom and get me hearts on the screen. After you get ready, give me hearts on the screen, everyone. Yes, hope everybody have taken. I need the hearts on the screen if you are perfect with your NCRT, a highlighter or a pen or wherever, or whatever in your hand in order to mark the important points along with the MCQs. Ready, everyone? Only one person is actually responding me on the chat box. I don't know where are the others. Yes, Dima is also responding. Okay, let's get started. Basics of classification. So if you have any doubt, just clarify the doubt right now, right here itself. So first we are going to discuss about what are the basics of classification. So among, we have different basics of classification, and the first one is the level of organization. The first one is the level of organization. Level of organization can be mainly of four types, that is the cellular level, tissue level, organ level, or the organ system level of organization. Cellular level means their body is composed of loose cell aggregates. Tissue level means their body is composed of certain substances known as cells to the level of tissues are present. In the organ, you have the organs, different organs present. And in the organ system, you will have the transformation of organs into organ system can also be seen in organ system level of organization. In case of cellular level, it is the porifera which is actually the example. Tissue level, the higher class, the higher phylum, that is Cnidaria and Ctenophora. Organ level of organization exhibited by platyhelminthes. Okay, actually platyhelminthes to chordates you can say, but mainly we write it as platyhelminthes. Okay, platyhelminthes is only essential as it determines, as it is actually mentioned in your NCRT, right? So that is only required. In organ system level of organization, you will have ash helminthes to higher chordates. Ash helminthes to chordates or higher animals. You can see this organ system level of organization. Thumbs up on the chat box, everyone. Thumbs up on the chat box, everybody, if it's clear. So you have to study the example, cellular level in porifera, tissue level in Cnidaria and Ctenophora, organ level in platyhelminthes, organ system level in higher animals. Is it clear? Perfect. Let's move on. Second one is the body symmetry. The second criteria which we take into consideration is the body symmetry. So mainly there are three types of symmetry, that is asymmetry, radial symmetry, and bilateral symmetry. Asymmetry, radial symmetry, and bilateral symmetry. I don't know whether Calvin is here because I'm not getting any kind of response from Calvin. Maybe writing out the notes, I don't know. Asymmetry means there is actually no symmetry. Asymmetry means no symmetry. For example, most poriferans, snail and all, exhibit asymmetry. Mainly when this kind of a question asks, you will write the example as poriferans. Phylum porifera is actually showing asymmetry. That is, they do not have any kind of specific body symmetry. Radial symmetry, that is, the body can be cut into two equal halves. The body can be cut into two equal halves along any plane, along any plane. For example, Cnidaria, some poriferans, Ctenophores, adult echinoderms, repeated previous year MCQ number one we are discussing. Repeated previous PYQ, just star mark or highlight this particular adult echinoderms. Adult echinoderms, clear? So adult echinoderms is actually showing what? Adult echinoderms show radial symmetry, but larvae of echinodermata, they show bilateral symmetry. That is, in case of bilateral symmetry, body can be divided into only two halves, that is right and left half, in only one particular plane. For example, flatworms to chordates, everything is bilateral symmetry. So these two diagrams are specifically given in your NCERT textbook. So they are previous year MCQ question, or they can be asked as an MCQ question in the upcoming year also. Is Nila there in the class? Is Shraddha there in the class? Is Calvin there in the class? No response. Okay, Calvin. Calvin, the problem, you know, you have been using a different font. You have been using a different font for answering. Just look, you have been using a bold kind of a font, right? It is not appearing on my screen. When I changed, the settings only I was able to know. When I changed the keyboard settings, I was able to see your charts. Yes. Yes, maybe they can ask you symmetry also. Name the kind of symmetry in which the body of animal can be cut into two equal halves through any plane. Then the answer is radial symmetry. Most probably such kind of a question may not come for your exam. Such kind of a direct based question may not come for your exam. Thing which may come for your exam will be like Which of the following organisms have a body which can be cut into two equal halves in any plane along the central axis? Then they contains mainly the option adult echinoderms or whatever, genophores, coelenterata, whatever, so that you can answer for that. Is that clear? Is it clear, everyone? So that is a kind. Calvin, is it clear? I replied you to your question. Okay. So third one is the embryonic layers. Third type is the embryonic layers. There are mainly two types of embryonic layer, that is the diploblastic layer and the triploblastic layer. Okay, the diploblastic layer and the triploblastic layer. So the diploblastic layer is actually consisting of the ectoderm and the endoderm only. Okay, the diploblastic layer consists of only ectoderm and endoderm. Okay, everyone. Look. They contains only ectoderm and endoderm. And they have not a developed, well-developed mesoderm, but they have a mesoglia. They have a mesoglia covering. So diploblastic animals consist of only ectoderm and endoderm. And their example is Cnidaria and Ctenophora. We won't include even the porifera into diploblastic content also, because they don't have any kind of well-defined system of embryonic layers. Okay. Okay, everyone. Yes. Then you have the triploblastic. They have ectoderm is there, mesoderm is there, endoderm is there. For example, from flatworms to chordates, you have what? You have a kind of triploblastic layer. So this is the mesoderm. So diagram A represent what? Diploblastic organism. And diagram B represents what? Triploblastic organism. They are previous year NEET MCQ question. This diagram was a frequently asked DBQ question. Clear? So please highlight. Please highlight, everyone. Please get it highlighted. Done. Done. Yes, thank you so much. So let's continue. Okay, so let's continue. Next is the coelom. Next is the coelom. I think it's better if I just highlight. Right. Next is the coelom. Clear. Coelom is actually a body cavity. It is actually, coelom is a cavity between the body wall and the gut. Coelom is actually the cavity between the body wall and the gut. So there are mainly three kinds, that is the acoelomate, pseudocoelomate and the coelomate. Acoelomate, pseudocoelomate and the coelomate. Acoelomate means they have no coelom. Pseudocoelomate, false coelom. And coelomate, they have a true coelom. Clear? So, one second, let me change it off. Yes. So acoelomate is actually having no coelom, and their example is from porifera to platyhelminthus. Whereas pseudocoelomate is actually frequently repeated MCQ question. They are having a false coelom, for example, in ash helminthus. From annelids to chordata, you will have a true coelom, that you will call them as coelomate, or you will call them as eucoelomate. You will have eucoelomate. Yes. Okay. So next is the metamerism. Next is the metamerism. Fifth point is the metamerism. Metamerism and the sixth one is the notochord. Metamerism is actually indicating the segmentation. Metamerism is indicating the segmentation, which is actually observed in annelids, earthworm, arthropods, and chordata also. Mark it out. Chordata. In chordata also. Notochord is actually a mesodermally derived rod-like structure present on the dorsal side of the embryo. They are seen only in chordata. Is it clear for everybody? Is that clear? The two statements, that is metamerism and notochord. Notochord, mesodermally derived dorsal side of the embryo. So those are the important points. Clear. So listen very carefully, all these things you know, so that I am going to have a quick recap. If you are confused with any points, just ask me right there itself. Clear. So listen very carefully. First is phylum Porifera. Phylum Porifera having a water canal system. Water enters through ostia, then spongocoel, and finally it reaches the osculum. Finally, it reaches the osculum. Spongocoel and canals are lined with choanocyte or collar cells. Body is supported by spicules or spongin fibers. Body is supported by spicules or spongin fibers. Example is the cycon, which is Kypha, Spongula, freshwater sponge, and Eusporgia, bath sponge. Clear? Guys, please respond me on the chat box as each and every topics get over. Each phylum gets over. Hit that box with the chat box. Just keep over there. Yes, sir, clear. So that I will be able to understand. Okay, thank you. So, let's move on. Second phylum is Cnidaria. Have cells, has splicing cells called blasting cells. They are called coelenterates. They have large astrovascular cavity called coelenteron with a mouth on the postus, on the postum. Guys, can you all hear me now? Is it clear? Can you all hear me now? Guys, can you all hear me now? Is it clear? Can you all hear me now? Guys, can you all hear me now? Yes. 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 It's clear. Yes, it's clear. So please tell me whenever there is a breaking in the audio. I've changed the network. Anyway, if you receive that once again, so please just inform me. Clear. So next, we were discussing about Sea Lanceraita, right? Sea Lanceraita or Nidaria. They have tentacles with nidoblasts or stinging cells. That is why they are called nidoblast. They have a gastrovascular cavity, Sea Lanceron, with a hypostome. They exist in two different forms, that is polyp and medusae. Polyp and medusae, they show alternation of generation, metagenesis. For example, Hydra, Obelia, Aurelia, Physalia, Portuguese man of war, Adamsia, sea anemone. So all these things are examples for what? Nidaria. Clear? Thumbs up on the chat box. Let's move on to the next one. Let's move on to the next topic right here, right now. Yes, everybody. Is it clear about phylum Nidaria and phylum Porifera? You have to study these important points in Porifera water canal system. Water, the flow of pathway is Ostia, Spongocoel and Osculum. Spongocoel and canals are lined with choanocytes or collar cells, which is exclusive character of Porifera or these sponges. Presence of choanocyte, previous year MCQ question. Exclusive property for poriferans. Body is supported by spicules and spongin fibers. Property of poriferans. And the example. Freshwater sponge, Spongilla. Bath sponge, Euspongia. Nidaria, you will have tentacles, nidoblast, gastrovascular cavity known as the Sea Lanceron, polyp and medusae form in Obelia, alternation of generation, which is metagenesis. And you will have examples. Hydra, Obelia, Aurelia, Portuguese man of war, sea pen, sea fan, penetula, brain coral, all these things, right? Yes. Next is next to phylum, that is Ctenophora or comb jellies. Locomotion is by ciliated comb plates. Show bioluminescence, ability to emit light. Example, Ctenoplana, Pleurobrachia. That's all about Ctenophora. That's all about phylum Ctenophora. Fourth one, Platyhelminthes. Fourth one, Platyhelminthes. Unsegmented body, dorsoventrally flattened. Excretion by flame cell, or you can call the flame cells can also be known as the flame cells can also be known as protonephridia. In most of the previous year NEET paper, they have included the term protonephridia instead of flame cell. If they ask you flame cell, you will definitely write Platyhelminthes. But protonephridia, when you hear about the nephridia, you will go out to other search of other options. Okay, so please remember flame cells or protonephridia. Parasites have hook and suckers. Example, Tania solium, tapeworm, fasciola, liver fluke, and planaria are examples of Platyhelminthes. So we have discussed about vital things. We have discussed about Ctenophora and Platyhelminthes in this slide. Clear? Remember about the protonephridia. Extra information told. Next to phylum, that is Ashelminthes, roundworm. Next to phylum is the Ashelminthes, roundworm. They are actually pseudocoelomate. Important point which I told you. Pseudocoelomate. Body is circular in cross section. Excretory tube is there to remove waste through the excretory pore. females are longer than the males. Those who have done the experiments in the lab and all, biology lab and all, you might have seen Ascaris, male and female. One is long, one is short. Females are longer than the male. Example, Ascaris, roundworm. Ancylostoma, hookworm. Butyraria, filarial worm are examples of what? Ash helminthus. No one is responding. Very good. Sixth one is the annelida, which is a segmented worm or ringed worm. That is, segmentation is present, as the name indicates. Annelida, they are the segmented worms. Longitudinal and circular muscle helps in locomotion. Previous year MCQ. Closed typo circulatory system. Setae is a locomotory organ in earthworm. Parapodia in nereus. Excretion by nephridia. Name the organisms or name the phylum whose organisms excrete by protonephridia. It is Platyhelminthes. Examples of Ferritema postuma, that is earthworm, Hirudinaria, leech, and the nereus are examples of annelida. Are examples of what? Are examples of annelida. Okay, let's move with the next one. Okay. That is, next one is Arthropoda. Arthropoda. Arthropoda, which is a jointed legged animals. Arthropoda, they have jointed appendages. Their body had head, thorax, and abdomen. Chitinous cuticle or chitinous exoskeleton. Malpighian tubule is excretory organ in most of the arthropods. Sensory organs are antennae, compound, and symbol eye. Statocyst, which is actually the balance organ. Examples are, economically important is the Apis, Bompex, and Lacifer. Yes, repeated question, Locusta. Yes, Nila, very good. It is the largest phylum. Living fossil, Limulus or King Crab. Limulus or King Crab. In the chapter Plant Kingdom, we study about another living fossil there also. Ginkgo biloba, there we study as living fossil in plant. Here it is Limulus, which is a king crab. Repeated question. Clear? Okay, so let's move it. Please refer, guys. I don't think it is there in the NCRT about the statocyst, balance organ. Just tell me, those who are in the class, just tell me if it is there on the NCRT or not about the statocyst. What happened, Calvin? Okay. Just tell me what is the importance of statocyst. Is there in the NCRT or not about the statocyst, which is acting as a balancing organ? Just tell me on the chat box. Guys, those who need not have the session or those who are not here to listen in the class, why are you back here for disliking the session? I don't think there is something illegal which has been teaching over here. Everything that is in the NCRT only is being taught. And I don't know why or who all are coming here for disliking the session. Let them do whatever they need because it's what they learned. It's what they learned. Okay. So next we have to learn about the last two phylums, that is the mollusca, soft bodied shelled animals. Okay, so please refer to that because maybe can be asked for the exam. Okay, now let's discuss about the mollusca, soft bodied shelled animals. Their body divided into head, visceral, hump and muscular foot. Their body have sensory tentacles. They have a calcareous shell, feather-like gills for respiration and excretion, mantle and radula, which is acting as a rasping organ. Example is Pila, apple snail, pearl oyster, Pinctada, Cypia, cuttlefish, Lolico, squid and octopus, devilfish. You have to refer these. Cypia, cuttlefish, it's not coming under fish, it is a mollusk. Octopus, devilfish, it is also a mollusk. It is not coming under where? It is not actually coming under the phylum Pisces or class Pisces. It is coming under mollusca. Done. Next is the echinodermata. Echinodermata or spiny skinned animals. Their adults are showing radial symmetry, larvae showing bilateral symmetry. Endoskeleton is of calcareous ossicles, spiny skinned body. They have a water vascular system. Comment on the chat box, guys, where we have studied about the water canal system. In which phylum is associated with the water canal system on the chat box, everybody? Water canal system, where we have studied. Water canal system, where we have studied. Absolutely, phylum Porifera is the answer. Okay, and water vascular system is being studied over here in phylum Echinodermata. Okay. So they are used for locomotion, food capture and respiration. Excretory system is actually absent. Asterisk, starfish, echina, sea urchin. Then Antidon, sea lily, cucuminaria, sea cucumber, Ophira, brittle star are examples of what phylum? Echinodermata. So these are some of the phylum which is coming under the class non-chordata or invertebrates. Okay. Yes, it's clear. So let's move on to the upcoming one. And before that, let me see how many slides are left behind. 14 to 24. Okay, let's move on. Next is the hemichordata. Next is the hemichordata. Okay, next is the hemichordata. Their body is formed of a proboscis, collar and a trunk. Guys, there is a user which is there. Guys, there is a user named Perfect on the chat box. So please report his account so fast, everybody. Nila and Calvin and everybody watching the session. Please report his account. Okay. He's sending some kind of unnecessary messages. Okay. So if actually this actually, I don't know whether how many of you know about it. Anyway, also I have also taken down what he has sent it down and taken his account. I'll be soon filing a petition in the cyber authority regarding the same for unnecessary usage of certain bad words in a comment section of a channel. Okay, so Mr. Perfect, soon you will receive the calls and the other formalities would be definitely done. Perfect. So be ready for all those things. And if you are a NEET aspirant, you will definitely be able to write the needs because my support will be there, right? Maybe question paper may come to a nearby jail or prison and make you write. I'll make that particular thing made for you because I don't want to lose 1 year. Okay. So you will definitely write your NEET exam if you are a NEET aspirant, but not in an exam center, but in some other place. Okay. So be ready for those things because of these bad messages which you're sending on the comment section of a channel. Clear? So be ready. I hope the person is hearing. So, collar bears stomachord. Collar bears stomachord. Excretion is done by the proboscis gland. Example is the balanoglossus, tongue worm, and sacoglossus are examples of hemichordata. Okay, so hemichordata body is formed of proboscis, collar and trunk. Collar bears the stomachord. Excretion by proboscis gland in examples is the balanoglossus, which is a tongue worm. And yes, guys, you won't hear that. You won't see that message because it's actually, I don't know how many of you know about it. It is actually one particular settings in the YouTube comment or chat box regarding if any bad words are included in any of your message, definitely it would be done for our review. The same thing happens in some of your case also. When some of you are sending some emojis, that is messages like thumbs up, hearts, if it excludes a particular number, if you are sending too much of messages, what happens? It would be done here for review. So if I just click the particular tab there, view the message or publish the message, then only you would be able to see that message as the public comments. Okay. Yes. So those who don't need the session, do not attend it. Nobody is just asking you compulsorily to attend the session, right? Guys, can you all hear and see the screen? Yes. So proboscis, collar, trunk. I think stomachord is a new term for all of you. Stomachord is actually a flexible and hollow. It is actually a tube, a flexible and a hollow tube, which is found in hemichordates. Okay, which is found in the hemichordates. Is it clear? Yes. Next diagram, diagram-based question is there. So make sure you write it. Okay, make sure you have. Okay, everybody, so please refer this diagram, phylum chordata, definitely a diagram-based question. Nerve cord, notochord. Guys, nerve cord is on the top. Okay, below the nerve cord only you will have the notochord. Okay, below the nerve cord, you will have the notochord. So nerve cord is the top first. Notochord is below that only. Then you have the posterior chain and the gill slit. These two parts all of you will label. You will be confused with these two parts, whether first one is the nerve cord or notochord. So just remember, nerve cord is the first and notochord is the second. Clear? Take a screenshot or else I'll provide the PDF so you can have a view on that. Notochord is absent in non-chordates. They are present in chordates. Central nervous system is dorsal in chordates. They are ventral in non-chordates. Pharyngeal gill slits are present in chordates. They are absent in non-chordates. Postchenal tail is present in chordata. Non-chordates, they are absent. Ventral heart in chordata. Dorsal heart in non-chordata. Phylum chordata is classified into three subphyla, that is urochordata, cephalochordata and vertebrata. Okay. Urochordata, Cephalochordata, and Vertebrata are the three different classes that comes under this. So listen very carefully, everyone. Urochordata. Notochord present only in larval tail. Example, Ascidia, Salpan, Duliolum. Yes, Nila, I'll provide in the group. Yesterday's session I provided, so today's session also I'll provide. Okay? I'll definitely provide. So, Urochordata is actually notochord present in the larval tail, Ascidia, Salpan, Duliolum. You have to study both. Second is Cephalochordata. Notochord extends from head region to tail and is persistent throughout the life. Branchiostoma, amphioxus, and lancelet. Third is a vertebrata or craniata notochord during embryonic period. It is replaced by a vertebral column in the adult. Paired appendages, fins or limbs are present. Okay, study what is urochordata. Notochord present only in larval tail. Example, Ascidia, Salpan, Duliolum. Cephalochordata, notochord extends from head to tail region. Persistent throughout the life. Amphioxus, lancelet, branchiostoma. Calvin, are you here? Vertebrata or craniata, notochord is present only during embryonic period, replaced by a bony cartilaginous vertebral column in case of adult. Okay, Calvin. So let's move on. Vertebrata is actually the phylum which is you are going to classify. It can be divided into two, that is Aknatha and Nathastomata. Aknatha means Aknatha. Means A means acoelomate. Asymmetry means neither. It's doesn't, it lack. So Aknatha lacks jaw. Nathastomata, it bears a jaw. Aknatha can be divided into class Cyclostomata. Nathastomata superclass into superclass Pisces, which can be divided into chondrichthyes and osteichthyes. Chondrichthyes, cartilaginous fish. Osteichthyes, bony fish. And superclass tetrapoda that bear limbs, class amphibia, reptilia, mammals, and aves. Okay, so let's discuss one by one. Let's discuss one by one. So listen very carefully. Class Cyclostomata. They all are ectoparasites. Elongated body without scale and paired fins. Sucking and circular mouth without jaws. They don't have jaws because they are coming under Aknatha. They are coming under Aknatha. So they are having only sucking and circular mouth without jaws. Cartilaginous cranium and vertebral column is present. They are marine but migrate for spawning to freshwater. For example, Petromycin, lamprey, mixin, hagfish. Okay. So remember these highlighted points. Okay, remember the highlighted points. Ectoparasite. Elongated body without scales. Sucking and circular mouth without jaws. Marine organism but migrate for spawning into freshwater. Example, Petromycin, lamprey, mixin, hagfish. Guys, in this chapter, you guys get confused with this idea. That is, they will trick you with the other names. That is, Petromycin, lamprey, mixin, hagfish. So study if such kinds of examples, a lot of examples are there. Reproduction for laying the eggs. Understood? For laying the eggs and all, they migrate to fresh water. When the egg hatches, what happens? These fishes come back to the marine aquatic organism, aquatic area. Clear? Next is the chondrichthyes. Class chondrichthyes is actually cartilaginous fishes. Cartilaginous endoskeleton, number point number one. Just mark it along with me. Cartilaginous endoskeleton, point number one. They have a ventral mouth. Gill slits without operculum. Operculum is not present. Skin with placoid scale. No air bladder is present. No, so needs to swim to avoid sinking. In males, pelvic fin bears claspers. Internal fertilization. Viviparous. Example, Scoldion, dogfish, Pristis, sawfish, great white shark, trigon, torpedo, all these things are examples of chondrichthyes. So once again, let me highlight for your kind information. So listen, cartilaginous, ventral mouth without operculum, placoid scale, no air bladder, pelvic fins, bare claspers, internal fertilization, viviparous, along with the examples. Okay, along with the examples you have to study in order to make this clear. Okay, in order to make this clear, you have to study it along with the examples. Class osteichthyes, which is actually the bony fishes, bony endoskeleton. They have a terminal mouth. Four pairs of gills are there, which are covered by operculum, Scales are cycloid or tenoid. Air bladder is present. External fertilization. And mostly oviparous. So guys, these examples of bony fishes are previous year MCQ question, even CBSE class 12th board exam question. Sorry, CBSE class 12th 2020 board question also was one of this example. Okay, it comes very little apart, comes in about the fishes, blue revolution and all comes in the chapter strategies of human welfare. But the same question was asked over there, example of freshwater fish. Name two or three freshwater fishes. That was the question. So flying fish, Exocetus, Hippocampus, Labia, Catla, Claris, Beta, Pterophyllum, angelfish. So all these are important. Highlighting bony, terminal mouth, four pairs of gill slits covered by operculum, cycloid or genoid scale, air bladder is present, external fertilization, oviparous, and they are the previous year MCQ. Okay, they are the previous year MCQ question. Done, everybody. Let's move on. Superclass Tetrapoda. First is about the class Amphibia. Live in aquatic and terrestrial habits. Why is they called Amphibia? They can live in both aquatic and terrestrial habits. Need water for breeding. They have moist skin without scale. Amphibia have moist skin without scales. Then they have cloaca. Examples, Bufo, Rana, Hyla, Salamandra, Ichthyopus, limbless amphibian. Any of this question paper you can refer. Have written the names of so many. You can refer any, either AIMS, AIPMT, NEET, JIPMER, AFMC, BHU, KCET. Any question paper you can refer. So in this all question paper, you will find this question. Ichthyopus limbless amphibian. Because it is a very important question. Ichthyopus is a limbless amphibian. Similarly, like this, living fossil, what? Limulus, king crab, living fossil. It can also be a previous, it can also be a repeated question. It is also a repeated question. The perfect person have gone. The perfects. Where is my Mr. Perfects? Gone. I hope maybe feared. Talking about the case and all, maybe feared. Yes. Gone with the life, right? So back to the class. We don't have time to spare for such silly matters. Yes, next is class Reptilia. Dry and cornified skin, very important. Class Reptilia have dry and cornified skin. Epidermal scales or scutes, epidermal scales or scutes. Crawling locomotion. Examples is chelon, Twestido, Chameleon, Caltis, Crocodiles, Alligator, Hemidactylus, Naja, Bancherus, Vipra. Guys, please refer. Your NCERT Bible. Okay, in that NCERT Bible, you will find certain, especially this case. Okay, especially that case. You will find something that is. Poisonous snake, non-poisonous snake and all you will find over there. So class Reptilia, dry and cornified skin, epidermal scales and scutes, crawling locomotion, and the examples are the important question from this area. Last part, that is a class Aves and class Mammalia. Class Aves and class Mammalia. Feathers. We haven't noted, Calvin. I haven't noted. Please wait. I was just reading out those things on the slide. One second, let me clarify that since you had a doubt. What happened, Calvin? No. That's why I haven't noted it at the first attempt when I read. Yes, Bufo, Rana, Hyla, Salamantra, Ichthyopus. Examples of class Amphibia. Okay. So class A is feathers, beaks and wings. Dry skin without glands. Hind limbs have scales. Pneumatic bones are the characteristic feature of class Aves. Digestive tract is crop and gizzard. Name the other area where we studied about the same. In one more area we studied about the same like this. Digestive tract, crop and gizzard. Where cockroach, Periplaneta americana, belonging to the phylum. Right, everyone. Cockroach, Periplaneta americana, belonging to the phylum Arthropoda. In the digestive system, in the chapter structural organization, we learned, right, crop and gizzard. Example of certain birds are given. Last is class Mammalia, mammary glands, exclusive character. Calvin, the best thing which you can do is that just take a piece of a paper. Okay, today itself, before you sleep, today do this. Just take out a piece of a fresh sheet of a white paper. Then you write each phylum with, do not need to write any properties or anything related there. You have to simply mention Porifera, write the examples. Coelenterata, write the examples. Ctenophora, write the examples. So up to class Mammalia, write the examples. Not from any reference guide or reference material or wherever. Write it, those examples which are mentioned in your NCERT only. You should not confuse yourself by writing the examples from other textbooks and notebooks. Write examples which are mentioned in your NCERT only. For the next 1 week, it has to be there in your hand wherever you go. Okay, wherever you go, it has to be there in your hand so that you have to keep on revising the same. You have to keep on revising the same so that it would definitely touch your mind. Okay, this is the same thing which I tell to everybody. I don't know how many of you do. For the last minute revision and all, you can just make out a synopsis of each chapters. That is, you can take out a piece of paper, you can make out the entire concept of that chapter, entire concept of the chapter in one particular page so that it may be useful for you to read in the day before the exam. Clear? Taking out the chapter Living World, writing all the important points which can be asked. Or or which topic which I am forgetting always, you can take it down on a fresh sheet of a paper from each chapter and you can tie it or pin it at the last of your NCRT, okay, of each chapter. Maybe have some water. Let me have some water. Okay, Calvin. Class Mammalia is a skin with hair, teeth, different types are there, viviparous. Example, Ornithorhynchus, Macropus, Pteropus, Camelus, Rattus, Canis, Felis, Elephas, and Equus. Okay, different names, right? Feeling right, something. Okay, they are all the scientific name. Yes, hit the chat box with hearts if you are clear with this chapter. If you are clear with the chapter, just hit the chat box with hearts. I don't know how many of you have read the banner which is there on our screen. The banner which is actually running over in this particular place. In below of our screen, there is a one banner. I don't know how many of you have read that. Tell me. Frankly, tell me how many of you have read the banner which is over here. In this particular area, you have a banner. Scrolling thing, a scrolling message is there. How many of you have read that? That's a very important statement. Am I right? Very important, right? Do you think it's an important one? Success is the sum of small efforts repeated day in and day out. There are no elevators for success, but you have to climb the difficult steps to achieve success, right? So that's all for today. This is from your channel. It's me signing out from your channel, BioPoint, stream the world of bio. Yes, don't forget to hit the like button, share it with your friends, and subscribe this channel. Bye bye, guys. Hope the session was useful for each one of you. Yes, everybody. Thank you, guys. Thank you so much. Practice the MCQs of the session today itself. Okay? Practice the MCQs of the session today itself. Or by tomorrow morning. Revise the chapter today. Do the MCQs tomorrow morning. Don't leave it or keep it aside simply. Okay? So, bye-bye, guys.